Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton are going strong in the Super Tuesday primaries. The 88th Academy Awards brought both awards and controversy. CSUN students learned the importance of eating disorder awareness.
This is Valley View News.
Hello, and welcome to Valley View News. I am Desiree Lopez.
And I'm Delmi Moran.
Hillary Clinton has swept to a huge victory in the Democratic Super Tuesday primaries.
Thank you. Thank you all so much. What a Super Tuesday. You know, all across our country today, Democrats voted to break down barriers so we can all rise together.
Donald Trump has swept to a huge victory in the Republican Super Tuesday primaries.
You know, I watched Hillary's speech, and she's talking about wages have been poor, and everything's doing badly, but we're going to make it. She's been there for so long. I mean, if she hasn't straightened it out by now, she's not going to straighten it out in the next 4 years. It's just going to become worse and worse. She wants to make America whole again, and I'm trying to figure out what is that all about. Make America great again is going to be much better than making America whole again.
Ted Cruz and Marco Rubio offered some competition. And this year, the Oscars took a powerful approach concerning social issues happening worldwide. Stephanie Lopez has more on this story.
Oscar turned 88 last Sunday on a night that featured diversity and other issues along with an array of stars. Director Tom McCarthy's film Spotlight took home the award for Best Picture. Leonardo DiCaprio won Best Actor for his role in the film Revenant. Brie Larson won Best Actress for her role in the film Room. Director Alejandro Iñárritu won Best Director for his film The Revenant. The biggest upset of the night came when Mark Rylance took home the award for Best Supporting Actor in the film Bridge of Spies. Alicia Vikander took Best Supporting Actress for her role in The Danish Girl. Mad Max Fury Road won 6 awards over the course of the evening. The Oscars were filled with many memorable moments in addition to the awards. Host Chris Rock quickly brought up the controversy over the lack of diversity.
Well, I'm here at the Academy Awards, otherwise known as the White People's Choice Awards.
Rock said African Americans have dealt with much bigger issues in the past than Oscar diversity.
Too busy being raped and lynched to care about who won Best Cinematographer.
In recent years, the issue of racism in Hollywood has been brought up often. Studies show a lack of roles for actors of color.
We want opportunity. We want the black actors to get the same opportunities as white actors. That's it.
While accepting his award for Best Actor, Leonardo DiCaprio talked about the dangers of climate change.
Climate change is real. It is happening right now. It is the most urgent threat facing our entire species. Let us not take this planet for granted. I do not take tonight for granted. Thank you so very much.
Vice President Joe Biden made an appearance and touched upon the issue of sexual assaults. Biden asked people to join him and take a stand.
A pledge that says, I will intervene in situations when consent has not or cannot be given. Let's change the culture. No abused woman or man, like the survivors you will see tonight, ever feel they have to ask themselves, what did I do? They did nothing wrong.
His speech was followed by Lady Gaga's performance of her rendition of the Oscar-nominated song, Till It Happens to You. Survivors of sexual abuse joined her on stage with messages on their arms such as, not your fault. That's all we have for now. We will have more on entertainment later on. Now back to Desiree.
The federal government says 1 in 5 women on college campuses has been sexually assaulted. Last year, 6 sexual assaults happened on CSUN's campus. CSUN Police Department's Captain of Special Services, Scott Banskoy, says sexual assaults are underreported, but believe his department is well-equipped to combat the issue.
We have, you know, our blue light phones. We've added cameras, CCTV cameras around campus. We have 150. We're adding another 150 here within the next year. It's state-of-the-art analytic capability. I could spend half the day talking about that, but it is state of the art. And we also have amber light patrols where we actually have our matter of patrol safety escort carts in our parking units with their lights on certain hours of the nights when we know that there is a higher level of incidents going on in a given area, just for visibility.
The police department isn't the only ones getting involved. CSUN Athletics and other students' organizations participate in the It's On Us campaign, which teaches students how to be more than just a bystander and help end campus assaults. The campaign also teaches the students how to look for signs of sexual assault and encourages them to intervene.
California lawmakers have submitted 20 new bills to stiffen the laws on human trafficking. The lawmakers submitted the new bills before the mandatory February 19th deadline. The bills are aimed at taking the blame off of the victims and making it easier to prosecute traffickers. Officials say the bills will also offer victims immunity from crimes and the ability to clear their records.
It's winter, but feels like summer. This weather is attributed to El Niño. CSUN Geography Professor Emily Orm says Southern California is not experiencing typical wet El Niño weather.
The jet stream this year has been diverted to more northerly latitudes. As a result, the blocking high pressure, which is over the Great Basin and which is over California, has prevented these storms from actually coming into Southern and Central California.
Orm says El Niño is also affecting the drought because of less snowfall in the Sierras.
We need about 250 to 260% above average snowfall and rainfall in both the northern and the southern Sierra.
Right now, the snowpack is about 82% above normal. Meanwhile, expect more sunny weather in the Southern California over the next several weeks. However, if you're headed to the beach, beware of the high surf advisories because of El Niño.
Over 30 million people suffer from an eating disorder in the U.S. A student peer education group known as Joint Advocates on Disordered Eatings is bringing awareness to this issue. Valley View News reporter Rosa Rodriguez has more on the story.
This group of JADE volunteers at CSUN is working to educate students about eating disorders. They discuss eating disorders such as bulimia, anorexia nervosa, and binge eating in the student union. Volunteers talked to students individually and gave out pamphlets. Many students suffered from eating disorders themselves or know someone who had.
I suffered from purging disorders, and it was like a constant battle that I had for many years. And going through that, not only did it help me want to help out other people, I actually became a psychology major, and I'm majoring to specialize in helping people who suffer from eating disorders, anorexia nervosa, bulimia, binge, purge, all of that.
JADE creates awareness of eating disorders through outreach workshops and art displays such as these. This Eating Disorder Awareness Museum shed light on the different types of eating disorders as well as facts, myths, and statistics.
Eating disorders is something that people don't really consider a disorder. They don't consider it to be that serious. So I feel like this is a good opportunity to spread proper awareness and help other people, especially the students here.
Students also engaged in activities such as bead making and writing positive messages to others.
I think it's just great to be able to talk about this stuff because there's such a stigma with eating disorders and depression and suicide, and I think it's great that we can just kind of talk about it and do it in a fun and healthy way instead of making it sound scary.
About 60% of students know someone who has or had an eating disorder, according to recent studies.
Eating disorders is an issue. It's affecting over 3,500 students approximately on this campus, and I'd love for students to be able to receive services to be treated for whatever thing that they're experiencing around body image.
JADE is just one of three programs on campus that offers help and support for students who are experiencing eating disorders and related issues such as depression and suicidal thoughts. From Cal State Northridge, this is Rosa Rodriguez for Valley View News.
The Center for Disease Control reports that the flu vaccine this year is 60% more effective than it has been in the past years. The CDC says the flu this year is not dangerous and many people do not even need the shot.
The first uterus transplant in the U.S. was performed last week. The operation lasted 9 hours and was performed at the Cleveland Clinic. This gives women without a uterus the chance to have babies. It takes 1 year to heal. Doctors will implant embryos that were created before transplant using in vitro fertilization. Then transplanted uterus will be removed after the woman has one or two babies. Sweden was the first country ever to have successful uterus transplant.
There has been a huge rise in the number of women getting mastectomies over the past decade. The U.S. Department of Health says more women are asking to get their breasts removed to prevent breast cancer. Some women have even asked for a double mastectomy. Breast cancer rates still remain the same, but the rate of women getting mastectomies has increased by 36%.
A new study says health warning labels on sugary drinks is making parents think twice before buying them for children. The research found that parents were less likely to choose a sugary drink for their child if those drinks had health warnings. Sugary beverages contribute to diabetes, obesity, and tooth decay. A bill is under consideration in California that will require sugar-sweetened beverages to include health warning labels on their packaging.
There's more on the Black Lives Matter movement. The Ducks defeat the LA Kings. NCAA basketball finishes the season. The California Democratic Party has endorsed Attorney General Kamala Harris for U.S. Senate. Harris is running against U.S. Representative Loretta Sanchez for the seat of retiring Senator Barbara Boxer. Harris received almost 80% of the party vote.
The California Supreme Court is clearing the way for Governor Jerry Brown to collect signatures for prison parole policy. This policy deals with parole eligibility for inmates serving time for nonviolent crimes. Prisoners who participate in the certain programs or earn enough good behavior credits may be considered for early release. Governor Brown says this will provide a stable solution to prison overcrowding. Voter signatures need to be collected for a November ballot measure.
The Supreme Court has turned down an appeal from three former NFL players who challenged the league in its use of player images in film footage. The players won $42 million settlement 3 years ago, but they complained that the financial payout would go to a fund aimed at benefiting former players instead of directly into their accounts. The Eighth Circuit Court of Appeals ruled that the settlement is fair and will benefit all former NFL athletes. That ruling now stands.
Now let's go to Jarvis Heron with sports.
Thank you, Desiree. The CSUN men's basketball team fell to Hawaii last weekend, 89-78. The Matadors kept close in the first half, but Hawaii picked up a lead early in the second half and kept it throughout the rest of the game. Senior Trahell Edmerson was not happy with the team's performance.
I said, I'm not even angry. I wasn't even angry tonight. The feeling I felt was more of an embarrassment because of the way that we played, and we had people come out to watch us play, and that's what we did.
Hale Edmerson led the team in rebounds with seven, moving him into fifth place all time on CSUN's rebound list. Aaron Parks led the Matadors in scoring with 18. The Matadors have one more game left this season. CSUN baseball has collected its 900th home victory. The Matadors defeated Northern Colorado last Saturday 4-2. Overall, the Matadors took 3 out of 4 against the Bears. They did it with timely pitching and hitting. First baseman Brandon Berry says the team's mindset is in the right place.
I mean, I think our chemistry is there. We just gotta continue having our swagger. Just continue building our swagger and having our routines and executing our routines. And just coming out every day and getting better day by day.
The Matadors are on a 4-game road trip. They return home March the 8th. To take on UCLA. The LA Kings and the Anaheim Ducks are in a tight race for the Pacific Division title. They squared off last Sunday in Anaheim. Let's go to the highlights. First period, Ducks on the power play. Ryan Getzlaff finds Sammy Vatanen, who dishes to Corey Perry, who goes up top for the score. Ducks take the early 1-0 lead. Let's go to the second period now. Score tied at 1. Crazy play here. Ducks try to clear the puck in their own zone, and craziness happens. Puck deflects off the boards, and Tanner Pearson ends up with it at the front of the net, finishes it off. He gives the Kings a 2-1 lead. Later on in the second period, Ducks back on the power play. Puck ends up in the hands of Cam Fowler. He shoots, rebounded by Corey Perry, who puts it in at a very steep angle, tying the game up at 2. Jump ahead now to the third period, early in the third. Loose puck in the Kings zone, and it ends up back in the hands of, you guessed it, Perry again. His third goal of the night, his 9th career hat trick. That would go on to be the game winner. The Ducks win the game 4-2, and they'll play the Kings one more time before the end of the season. Jimmy Johnson has tied Dale Earnhardt on the NASCAR career wins list. Johnson picked up his 76th career victory at the Atlanta Motor Speedway. Kevin Harvick led for 131 laps. But that lead went away when Harvick made his last green flag pit stop. Harvick made up ground on Johnson, but thanks to a crash on the backstretch, Johnson was able to hold on for the victory. Johnson says tying Earnhardt is special, and he gives him a little bit of an attachment to the NASCAR legend. The Angels and Dodgers have kicked off their spring training exhibition season in Arizona. The Angels look to return to the playoffs behind their star center fielder Mike Trout, but questions surround first baseman Albert Pujols as to whether he'll be healthy enough for opening day. The Dodgers are going for their fourth straight NL West title with their new manager Dave Roberts. The Angels open their season on April 4th in Anaheim against the Cubs, while the Dodgers will begin their season on the same day in San Diego against the Padres. That's all for sports. Let's go to Delmi with more news.
Black Lives Matter and the gay and lesbian community held a joint meeting at the student union. Valley View News reporter Taylor Nwanko has more on the story.
The two groups came together for this lecture and discussion. The audience was made up of students from all backgrounds, from CSUN's Gay and Lesbian Pride Center and Black Lives Matter. The goal was to begin to merge Black Lives Matter with other cultural organizations. Cameras were not allowed to record the discussion because of students' privacy. The students heard from Black Lives Los Angeles chapter representative, Pove Tamu Bryan.
If I'm thinking about the experience of black queer folks, then I'm also thinking about the experience of queer folks, period. So I think that that involvement, that investment makes a lot of sense, because if we're having an intersectional approach, if we're really trying to think about these things, then we're recognizing that all of our freedoms are bound up in each other.
This meeting not only brought white and black students together, it allowed black gay students to participate in two causes. Senior Melissa Ellswick says Black Lives Matter movement and queer involvement tie in with each other.
I mean, the main way they correlate is that a lot of blacks who do identify as queer are actively involved in the Black Lives Matter movement. And just with them being active, it automatically is interconnected that way.
Those identities have to always come together, as do the multiple identities that black folks carry, but specifically black queer folks in this conversation.
In Northridge, Taylor Wonko, Valley View News.
A Ku Klux Klan rally in Anaheim last weekend erupted in violence and left 5 people injured and 13 arrested. 3 anti-Klan protesters were stabbed, 1 is in critical condition, 2 Klan members were roughed up, and 1 is in serious condition. Police say anyone with cell phone video should contact authorities.
A Virginia police officer was killed on her first day on the job. She was sworn in last week. Prince William County Police Officer Ashley Gundon was killed while responding to a domestic-related shooting. The suspect is also accused of killing his wife. 2 other officers were shot, and 1 is in critical condition.
A man who was shot and killed while chasing a purse snatcher has been identified as 37-year-old Savoy Nice Anderson. The shooting took place last weekend in downtown Los Angeles. During the chase, the suspect pulled out a gun and shot Anderson. The suspected shooter has been described as a black male.
3 Florida students are facing felony charges after one of them allegedly poured red hot pepper flakes into their teacher's can of soda. 1 student was upset about a previous punishment. The 12-year-old brought the red pepper flakes and poured them into her teacher's drink. The teacher's throat began to burn and she had trouble breathing. The 2 other students allegedly distracted the teacher during the incident.
More on the Oscars protest and the rise in Disneyland prices.
And Yoko Ono when we come back. Mark Zuckerberg is opening up about his fear of the threats made against him by ISIS. In an interview with a German newspaper, Die Welt, he admits to be very concerned. Last week, ISIS created a 25-minute video threatening to take down Facebook and Twitter. They also made direct threats to Zuckerberg and Twitter CEO Jack Dorsey. The video is in response to the company's efforts to stop terrorist activity on their networking websites.
Following the December terrorist attack in San Bernardino that killed 14 people, the FBI is asking Apple to create a backdoor that will allow them to access information in the suspect's iPhones. Police are asking Apple to write software that will allow them to break into the phone and possibly gain information that could give them the motive for the attacks or perhaps the names of other terrorists. Apple has refused to write the software, but the FBI has given them the option to write software and then erase it. Apple has declined to do that also. Wade Chumney is an assistant professor at business ethics and law here at CSUN. He agrees with Apple.
From Apple's perspective,
if, you know, the FBI in our country obtains access to this, they would argue that, you know, what if China wants access, a backdoor access to one of their devices in order to go after political dissidents or something like that. So they don't want the government having this type of access here because of what it may mean for them down the road.
Apple and the government are now battling this issue out in court.
Now let's go to Stephanie Lopez for a second look at entertainment. The National Action Network and Reverend Al Sharpton led the protest before Oscars this week. Demonstrators expressed their disappointment at the lack of diversity. Valley View News reporter Mariah Robinson has more on this story.
Demonstrators rallied near Hollywood High School this week against the lack of diversity at the Oscars. The National Action Network and Reverend Al Sharpton led the demonstration. Supporters said the Oscars need diversity.
So many black people have dead movies that need to be recognized. So for us to, you know, just come out and make noise and, you know, hopefully next year we will be able to be nominated for something.
Guest speakers at the rally expressed why they weren't supporting the Oscars this year. People of all ethnic backgrounds showed their concern by rallying. Demonstrator Ernest McBride says minorities need to be in positions of authority to make a change.
The whites control the money, they control the, you know, the wealth, and they control the ideas. And until other people can gain the power, access and all, and control the money, the ideas, and the assignments, you know, that it will remain the same.
Demonstrators hope that next year's Oscars will reflect diversity in award nominations.
In Hollywood, I'm Mariah Robinson for Valley View News. Disneyland is raising its prices again. The new pricing policy will be designated either as a value day, regular day, or peak day. Value day admission will cost $95, regular day $105, and peak admission $119. The new prices will apply to one-day tickets. Disney says the new pricing policy is a crowd management technique. These new prices will start tomorrow. They will affect Disney World in Florida and Disneyland in Anaheim. MAC Cosmetics announced last week their new partnership with E! Star Caitlyn Jenner. This makes Jenner the most high-profile transgender star to get a major cosmetic contract. MAC said in a statement that Jenner has become to represent courage, fearlessness, honesty, and compassion. They added that all her sales will go towards programs aimed at transgender communities. Jenner's lipstick, Finally Free, launches April 7th. Singer-songwriter Yoko Ono has been released from the hospital in New York after being treated for the flu, not a stroke as many media outlets had suggested. The 83-year-old award-winning producer and artist was checked in a hospital in Manhattan last Friday. Ono-san reacted to the stroke rumor by tweeting, "Only stroke Yoko Ono had was a stroke of genius. She's really fine. Thanks for all the well wishes. Big love, Sean." Ono was the wife of late Beatles singer John Lennon. That's all for entertainment. Now let's go back to Desiree with more news.
Oil prices have increased 30% over the past 11 days. The International Energy Agency says global production has reached a record high, but prices have increased because producing countries have left oil off the market. Russia, Saudi Arabia, and other countries agreed to a deal on February 17th, but major producers like Iran have not cooperated.
The National Association of Realtors says the number of home sales decreased in January. Sales went down 2.2%. The decline is blamed on a shortage of properties. Steady job growth and low mortgage rates have bolstered demand, but the tight inventories have fueled price increases twice those of wage increases.
Food truck businesses are booming in Chatsworth. Customers are seeing it as a healthier and inexpensive alternative to mainstream restaurants. Valley View News reporter Caroline Hojikian tells us more about the experience.
Here in Granada Hills on Chatsworth Street, dozens of food trucks are lining up every Friday to serve the local food enthusiasts. Most customers enjoy the quick service of a truck, and many prefer it over a restaurant.
Most of the stuff here is actually authentic, fresh food. If it's not authentic, it's at least fresher than what you would get at a restaurant, depending, and better priced.
Throughout the past 5 years, these trucks have bought gourmet-style cuisine at an affordable price. Customers have the option of choosing different dishes, from unusual tacos to Asian-styled ice cream. One Cali Fresh food truck worker enjoys being in touch with the people she serves.
You're outside all the time. You get to serve people, make your food. It's also interacting with people a lot, like talking to customers. It's cool. I like that. It's like different from your outside job.
But the long wait line is a common dislike shared between most customers.
It would be nice to have, like, you know, the line, if the lines were a lot shorter, because, you know, you have to wait a long time in a line for a food truck you want to go to.
Dreamy Creations food truck owner Jenica Braddock explains how hard it can be to own a food truck.
A lot of people don't understand the costs that businesses have, and they think it's just like a money cow.
But with her title as a two-time Food Network Cupcake Wars winner, business comes flying in.
So it's been great publicity. When you see that, people are like, oh, I have to try it. So it's really exciting.
If you're looking for your Friday night fix, these food trucks have a variety of options for everyone's cravings. This is Caroline Hogigian in Chatsworth for Valley View News.
Thanks for watching Valley View News. I'm Delmi Moran.
And I'm Desiree Lopez. Have a great day.